So would it be right to say that it isn't politically motivated, but you believe you will not get a fair trial in the Philippines? Because politically motivated...
Ma'am, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Well, I'm sorry, you were garbled. Timor-Leste is the world's fourth slowest internet. Could you please repeat the last question?
Okay, based on just what you said, would it be fair to say that it's not politically motivated, but you believe you will not get a fair trial in the Philippines? Because to establish political, that something has to be politically motivated means you are political opponent somehow. And yet he was not a political opponent of the Marcoses. He was with the majority in Congress.
Correction. He was a political opponent. First of all, he supported the presidential bid of Manny Pacquiao. Number two, he was speaking strongly against the Maharlika Sovereign Fund. That is a matter of record. Number three, he spoke strongly against the practice of government of forcing the generals to submit their courtesy resignations. On so many issues, he went against the government, and he has never joined the party of the speaker. He remained with his own party. So that qualifies him as a member of the opposition.
All right. I may not agree with that, but on that note, you are his lawyer. What is the next plan? So you have an extradition hearing. How long will this go on?
Well, we have other witnesses who will testify. My testimony is true. It was done yesterday. Former Human Rights Commissioner Soriano will be testifying today. And so with former Presidential Chief Legal Counsel Salvador Panelo and a few other lawyers. Yesterday also, a victim, one of his staff members was a victim of torture and who formally complained before the Commission on Human Rights, gave her story about how she was being forced to implicate Mr. Tevez. That is why we believe we cannot get a fair trial because, you know, you mentioned De Lima. When the witnesses of De Lima recanted, she was granted bail. And that was at a later stage of the trial. In this case, all 10 witnesses against Mr. Tevez recanted very early on before the preliminary investigation of the DOJ. Yet, they still filed a under normal circumstances, in experience as a lawyer for 32 years, if witnesses recant before the preliminary investigation, the case is it was not done.
All right. Well, on that note, I think the big difference also is the fact that De Lima, despite her believing that the charges were unfair, she submitted herself to the authorities' attorney. She was in jail for 6 years, considering she was innocent. And yet Arnulfo Tevez, considering he is a lawmaker, became a fugitive. He escaped instead of actually putting himself to a higher standard and submitting himself before the law, when the irony is he's a lawmaker. That's
same thing was done by Panfilo Lacson. He called it a fugitive from injustice. And yet we do not hear that kind of condemnation from anyone after Mr. Lacson was acquitted ultimately by the courts. So different strokes
but do
for
you
different
believe,
folks.
Do you believe that Arnulfo Tevez's case and Panfilo Lacson was the same?
Well, they both claim political persecution. That is the claim of Mr. Lacson. He even made a movie out of it called 10,000 Hours, where he was played by Robin Padilla. So the allegation on the part of Mr. Lacson is clear. He even made the privilege speech pointing to me as his political persecutor under the control of Mrs. Arroyo. So I think that cases are similar. I was also involved in that Lacson case as in this time as a prosecutor, as a counsel for Colonel Mangkaw. So I know the facts very well.
Okay, well, on that note, so how long is the hearing going to go on?
It should end, Ma'am Karen, by the 17th. We have hearings now because it's not a holiday here. So I will still be expected to be in court to lend moral support to Commissioner Soriano and to deal with other motions before the court.
Okay, so if the extradition hearing ends on the 17th, when will the court decide?
I will have to ask my counterparts here in Dili. Dili ko alam eh. Kasi iba po yung procedure nila.
Oo, oo. Because kapag nag-decline, then is there room for appeal for the Philippine government?
Yes. No, well, either way, whoever is not favored in the extradition hearing will have the right to appeal to a higher court. And in the meantime, if it is if the ruling is against us, the extradition is stayed until after the termination of the appeal, just like in the Philippines.
All right. Another question is, you are the lawyer of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy.
I'm sorry po, that last one came in garbled also.
Okay, you are
the
lawyer.
Pardon the internet here.
You are the lawyer of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy.
Yes, I'm one of the lawyers po, Ma'am Karen.
Okay, is he still in the Philippines?
Of that, I have no knowledge, Ma'am Karen.
Okay, and I have another question for you as a lawyer. Why do you choose to defend individuals who will not face the court of law? Pastor Apollo Quiboloy is a fugitive as well. He is in hiding. And Arnulfo Teves, I mean, why are you drawn to these clients?
Well, I'm not drawn to these clients, ma'am. Legal ethics prohibits from soliciting clients. It appears that they are drawn to me. Akala yata nila magaling ako sapagkat nag-guest ako sa Head Start. Eh, akala lang nila yon.
Pero ang tanong ko, like si Apollo Quiboloy, if you're one of his lawyers, you don't have information if he's still in the Philippines or not?
Ma'am, it's the client who chooses what kind of information he gives us. And ultimately, whether they go into hiding or they face justice, it's their own choice. We try to give them our best advice, but of course, ultimately, it is the client who chooses the path that his case will take. We can only render legal assistance, legal counsel, but we cannot provide personal counsel. That is beyond the scope of our advocacy.
No, but then you talk on the phone, do you? How do you communicate?
I have not communicated with Mr. Quiboloy for some time. Of course, with Mr. Teves, he is allowed to communicate with his lawyers whenever his counsels visit him. He is allowed to relay information to me in the Philippines through his Timor-Leste counsels. And we regularly exchange notes with my counterparts here in Dili.
All right. My last question is, do you believe Pastor Apollo Quiboloy will remain in hiding until the end of President Marcos Jr.'s term?
Well, I have no information sufficient to form an opinion on that. I think we, at the moment, we shall have to leave the situation as it is. But I think there is a biblical quote to that. I think it is in John. It says, "Hahanapin ninyo ako, ngunit hindi niyo ako matatagpuan."
I don't think that biblical quote belongs to him. This is a man who is accused of trafficking children. That does not belong to him. But on that note, I want to thank
word
you.
Is accused, not That's, convicted.
But that
accused.
Does not belong to him. All right? That particular biblical quote. But on that note, thank you very much, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right. We're going to thank you.